हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू ऑल। आई एम तपन कुमार बेहरा, योर इंग्लिश मेंटर। टुडे आई हैव बॉट वन ऑफ द मोस्ट डिमांडिंग टॉपिक्स। यू नो व्हाई आई से इट इज मोस्ट डिमांडिंग? बिकॉज इन ईच एंड एवरी एग्जामिनेशन एंड पर्टिकुलर इन प्रीलिम एग्जामिनेशंस, व्हाट फ्रॉम दिस टॉपिक यू विल गेट मिनिमम 5 to 10 मार्क questions. Okay, sometimes we'll get 5 mark questions or sometimes we'll get 10 mark question. That's why I say it is one of the most demanding topics. Don't take tension, my dear friends. Today I will tell something different, something new, something unique way which will help you to feel comfortable. Okay, I will release your tension. Don't take tension. Your tension is my tension. It is my duty to release your tension. Sometimes we feel what? It is quite impossible. It is very difficult to do. I can't do. Don't say I can't. Everyone always say I can. Because mind of friends, always one point keep in our mind, that is the sky is the limit. It means everything is possible if you think in positive way. Okay, let's start. Close test. Do you know what is close test? It is exactly, it is a paragraphs here, 5 to 10 blanks. If it is 5 mark question, then you'll get 5 blanks. If it is 10 mark question, then you'll get 10 blanks. Clear? Understood what I said? It is small paragraph. In that small paragraph, you'll get what? If it is 5 mark question, you'll get 5 blank. If it is 10 mark question, you'll get 10 blank. Okay. So, to fill each blank, you'll get 5 options in what? Banking. Clear? 5 blank. To fill each blank, you'll get 5 word options. From the given 5 word option, you have to choose which word is appropriate for that blank. Clear? Okay, let's see what happens, how I'll fill you what is yours and I'll release your tension. Okay, let's see what the problem we face in close test. My dear friends, to solve the close test, what happens? See, here I mentioned 3 things. 1 is vocabulary, number 2 reading speed, number 3 reading comprehension, which is a comprehension, comprehend, the power to understand. Clear? So generally these 3 things are essential for what? Close test. It means if you want to solve the close test, you have to focus on these following 3 things. Okay, first, why these 3 things? Let me explain. First, vocabulary. Aaj, to fill each blank, you will get some word options. Okay. So, if you know the meaning of word, then you can solve the question. If you don't know the meaning of words, you cannot solve the question. For being that, you have to develop your vocabulary power. You have built up your vocabulary word powers. Clear? Okay. Second thing is that reading speed, somehow it is very crucial matter for not only for close test but also for comprehension questions, paragraph completions, okay, sentence arrangement, I think each and every type of questions. Okay, because sometimes what happened in India, students are lacking in reading. Okay, due to that reasons they are unable to comprehend or understand the paragraph or questions. Okay, that's why they face many problems to give the answer of any questions. Okay, that's why you have to strong your reading speed. Okay, number three. Okay, reading comprehensions means you have to understand that paragraph. What does the paragraph want to say? What is the basic idea of that paragraph? Whenever you understand these three things, then you can solve your close test. Clear? Okay. But these are the common things each and everyone say in our country. Okay? Everybody says, without vocabulary, we cannot solve the close test. Without reading power, we cannot solve the close test. Without reading speed, we cannot solve the close test. But I will say something different today. It is my style. Okay? I will say, without reading, you can solve close test. Without vocabulary, you can solve the close test. Without reading speed, you can solve the close test. Okay? And here I will prove you whether it is possible or not. Why I say this one? Because my dear friends, what happened? It is my personal opinions. Okay? If some students, okay, if some student, they good at study, okay, they have word powers, they have ability to understand the sentence, they don't have any problem, they easily can they solve the questions. Okay, but think about those students are poor in study. They do not what understand the paragraphs. So what they will do? I'm thinking for those students. Okay, my motto, how student will get maximum mark, okay, and what qualify the exams. Okay, let's see, I'll prove here in this class whether it is possible or not. So that this video I divide in two parts. In first video I will tell all the rules and strategy where, and the second video I will give examples in one close test with having all difficult words. I will prove you without knowing the meaning of a single word you can solve the close test. Let's see. So what I said, understood past one paragraphs. If it is 5 mark question, you'll get 5 blanks. 10 mark question, you'll get 10 blanks. To solve the close test, these are the three essential things. Okay, let's see. Now we'll discuss about what is the crucials, okay, importance, strategy to solve the close test. Okay, let's see. Here I mention some strategy. Here, number one, vocab power. As I said just before a minute, okay, no doubt you have to little build up what your word power. Number two, read the passage. It means you have to read few lines. What I said, each and everybody says you have to, if you want to solve the paragraphs, it means you have to read the paragraph thoroughly, properly, once or twice. Mind your friends, I would like to ask you all, do you get that much of time in examinations? No. Rare you will get what? That much of a time to read once or twice that paragraph. So that it's my strategy. So if you want to solve the close test, if and you don't have the time to read that whole paragraph, better to read only 2 to 3 lines from the beginning. I think that is sufficient to solve the close test, and I will prove. Okay, so just you have to read 2 to 3 lines from the beginning, and so create and get a basic idea or objective of that paragraphs. Okay, next, number three, and the best way, the best strategy for the close test, if you want to feel easier, if you want to get maximum mark in minimum time, the best strategy, that is number 3 points. What? Number 3 point. Let's see. Eliminate the words which do not fit the meaning. Clear? It means the best way, that is eliminate the options. So there are 5 word options. You try to eliminate some word options which are false, which are inappropriate. How? Now those words do not fit as per the meaning or sense of that paragraph. So how will you eliminate? By the way, here one paragraphs which is based on social, My dear friends, the closed test comes from three topics. Number one, social. Number two, financial. Number three, environmental. Financial means as you people what prepare for banking examination mean that topic related to what? Bankings. Okay. Some topics come related to banking. And second point, what? Social. Social means relation between two countries. Clear? Number three, environmentals means what are the things happening in our environment. Okay, surroundings. These are the following three topics from which what the closed test is framed. Clear? So that, by the way, one paragraph is based on social issue. So five word options are given. You think which words are related or which words have link with the social issue. If some words don't have any relations with the social issue, it means easily we can eliminate those word options. So remaining 2 to 3 word options will think in different way. Clear? The first will try to eliminate some false option which what do not match as per the meaning with the theme of the paragraph. Clear? In this way we can eliminate 2 to 3 options. Okay. So next we'll think about the remaining two or three options. Fourth point, eliminate the words which do not match with the tone. Okay. Maybe you people ask me, sir, okay, in this way we can eliminate 2 or 3 word options, but what about the remaining 2 or 1 option? What will do? My dear friends, what happens in that case, also we can eliminate those word options and easily we can reach the conclusions what to get the correct and appropriate words for the missing blank. How? Now that is eliminate the words which don't match the tone. Means eliminate, reject the false answer word options which do not match with the tone. So what is tone? What is tone? Tone means the language of the paragraphs. Okay, tone means language of the paragraph, the approach of the paragraph. Clear? That tone I divide here in 5 category. Clear? One is, you can read, you can see, have a look. Number one, complaining. Number two, suggesting. Number three, critical. Number four, positive. In 4 category I divided what? The tones. Okay, if you think the paragraph tone is complaining, it means you have to choose what? The negative words for the blank. Okay, what does it mean? It means those words have positive meaning, easily we can eliminate those answers words, and those words cannot be the right choice for the blank. Clear? Okay. So if you think the paragraph tone is suggesting, it means that blank requires what? A positive meaning words. It means negative meaning words cannot be the right choice. We can eliminate. Sure. If you guess the paragraph tone is critical, in that condition, what happened, my dear friends? That blank requires either positive meaning word or negative. So here is one question. Clear? What? Now if the paragraph tone is critical, in such case, that blank requires a positive meaning word or negative. Clear? So here one question. Sir, how will you know whether this blank requires positive meaning words or negative? My dear friends, to know whether a blank requires a positive meaning word or negative, what will do? Take the clue of other words which are used before or after the blank. Okay? Very simple thing, my dear friends. What happened? If you want to know someone's character, someone's personality, okay? So you, what happens? See around his surroundings. Okay? Because from my surroundings, easily can know what type of person I am. Clear? Same thing. So if you want to know whether this blank requires a positive meaning word or negative, take the clue of other words which are used before or after the blank. If positive meaning words are used, then easily no doubt that blank require positive meaning words. If negative meaning words are used before or after the blank, it means that blank requires what? A negative meaning word. Clear? Using this process, this strategy also you can eliminate what? Some word absent. Automatically, so we'll get the right choice. Clear? Okay. So what other things you have to do? Okay. Let's see. Understood this one? So among the remaining options, mean if I don't think you'll get after using this following four step, you'll face any problem. By the way, if there are some following options, okay, are remained, okay, so you are unable to choose the right option, in that condition you apply your common sense or nuance. Common sense means what happened? This paragraph based on economy. So let's say whether which words have what link with the economy. Okay. And some other strategy. Now I'm going to tell to eliminate the rest of the option. If you, by in case you face any difficulties. Okay. Some following step. But before that, I would like to say what? Now here, one point. My dear friends, you have to keep this following points while you are solving the CLOT test. That is what? IET. IET means I for information, I for elimination, I for inference. Clear? Once again, what? I for information. What does it mean? Information mean this passage. What? Based on what? What does the paragraph want to say? Here, number two, elimination, which the best medicines for closed test. Okay. If poorer student also, what? Can solve the questions. Okay. Number three, what? Inference. If you follow these following three things, easily you can solve the CLOT test. Okay. Let's see. Okay, here the same thing here I mentioned, okay, on words you can read. Let's see how to tackle a close test. What are the things you have to do? Mind your friends, what you have to do? Listen carefully, attentively. Clear? What? A close test, if it is a paragraph, it is 5-mark question, then you get 5 blank. Fill each blank, you will get in banking, you will get 5 word option, SS you will get 4 word options. Clear? From the given 5 words, you have to choose which word appropriate for the blank. Clear? So, step 1, point 1, before fill any blanks, always take clue from the above sentence. Okay, before fill any blanks, always take the clue from the above sentence to know what type of word the blank requires. Clear? By the way, here blank number 1. Okay. We have to choose one word for this blank. Okay. To confirm what should be the correct word for this blank, what you do? You take the clue from the above sentence. Automatically you will get some link or clue from the above sentence. That word, some few words in the above sentence will give you some hints to know the correct word for this blank. Clear? Okay. Somehow, if you are unsure to fill that blank, you do not get any kind of a clue. Mind your friends, one more thing you do. Okay. Without wasting time, you skip that blank. Okay. Try to fill its next blank. After filling the next blank, automatically you get a basic idea, general idea to what? To know exactly the correct word options for that previous blank. Clear? Okay. Point 2. Each blank, you have to decide whether this blank requires a positive meaning word or negative. Clear? Each blank, you have to decide whether this blank requires a positive meaning word or negatives. If the blank requires positive meaning word, so choose the word which have positive meaning. Okay, if the blank requires negative meaning words, you think about negative meaning. Clear? So here once again the same thing I would like to repeat it. To know whether blank requires a positive meaning word or negative, take the clue of other words which are used before and after a blank. That what both sentence will give you clue whether blank requires positive or negative. Clear? In this way you can eliminate some false option or reach in the what? Right option. Clear? Point 3. Don't think the positive or negative meaning of each blank. Always think overall meaning of the paragraph. Clear? Okay. Don't think positive or negative meaning of each blank. Always think the overall meaning of the paragraph. Clear? Sometimes what happens, so from the given 5 word options, you'll think all words, you feel all word options are appropriate for the blank. Okay, you will get some words which will appropriate for the particular that blanks. But my dear friends, you have to think that word must be what? Appropriate as per overall of the meaning of the paragraph, not just for that particular blank. That point you must keep in your mind. Otherwise, what the things will happen, you know very well. Okay, next point, what you have to do? Each blank determine which part of speech the blank require. Clear? Determine or decide which part of speech the missing word is. Part of speech means what? Noun, pronoun, adjective or adverb. So what is the advantage of this strategy? My dear friends, let's see. Here one blank is given. Clear? We came to know that this blank requires a noun. Okay? So you check the options and think which words are noun. If those word options are not noun, it means those are not correct answer. Those are false. Clear? You have to choose the remaining what? Noun options. Clear? If you think this blank require adjective, just you have to choose the correct option only from the adjective, not from what? Other part of speech. What is the advantage? The advantage is that if you don't know the meaning of some words, okay, you will not face the problem. Why? We came to know that this blank require a noun. But here is a word options. We don't know the meaning of this word. But we know this is not noun. This is an adjective. This is an adverb. So what will happen? Easily we can eliminate, because those word options cannot be the right choice, because the blank require what? Noun. And these following options are adjective and adverb. This is the benefit of this strategy. Okay? Without knowing 60 to 70% words, we can solve the questions. Clear? Who says without meaning cannot solve the close test? I will prove without meaning you can solve the question. In the next part, I will bring some examples. Clear? Next one, next strategy, what you have to do. Clear? Next thing, that specially you take the clue of conjunction, preposition, punctuation mark like comma, or some related words which are used before and after the blank. Understood my point? What I said? Specially, before filling any blanks, special you take the clue of conjunction, prepositions, linking words or punctuation mark like comma. Why? Let's see. Let me explain. Here, one conjunction and. You know, my dear friends, and is a conjunction of a addition. Okay. After and, the blank is given. You know, and is a conjunction of addition, either it joins to positive meaning word or to negative. If one positive meaning word is used before and, it means this blank definitely requires one positive meaning words. If one negative meaning word is used before and, it means this blank require what? A negative meaning words. Means what? What does it mean? Mean those words have what? positive meaning, those option cannot be the right choice for the blank. Clear? In this way, we can eliminate some false option, even also we don't know the meaning of those words. Clear? Okay. So instead of but, if conjunction but is used, you know, but is a conjunction of a contrast. It join always contradict words, mean opposite words. It always join one positive idea, another what? Negative idea. It means if one positive meaning word used before but, so after but, the blank require what? A negative meaning words. Clear? If a negative meaning word used before conjunction but, it means what? This blank requires after but what? Negative positive meaning word. Clear? So this one will help you. And one more thing, I said you can also take the clue of preposition, because as for my knowledge, we'll see after most of the blank you definitely get what? Either conjunction or preposition. The same process, if you get any preposition after the blank, before thinking which words are appropriate for the blanks, first you think, if you use this word, after that this preposition can be used or not, whether you can use this preposition after those words or not. If the preposition cannot be used after those words or not, it means those words, prepositions, do not use after those following words, it means those word options cannot be the right choice. Please remember this one. Otherwise, as for the meaning wise, you choose the word, you think that it is suitable as for overall paragraphs, but it will be grammatically mistake. That's why I say, don't fill any blank only as for meaning. Again, don't fill any blanks only as for meaning. Always fill the blank both logically and grammatically. Means, to whatever the word will choose for the blank, that word must be correct in both logically and grammatically. Because a sentence, when you will say the correct, when it will be grammatically correct as well as logically correct. Clear? Okay. So you just, these are the following procedures, strategy you follow, and you, it is my promise to all of you, definitely feel comfortable and easily can solve the closed test. I hope you understood. Okay. Thank you.